What's going on, guys? It's Emazing. Today we're playing some ranked league with our boy Hecarim. I love Hecarim. Very versatile jungle hero. And we're going to start off with our basic jungle items to give us a little sustain in the jungle. Hecarim can, you know, go from getting pushed around to just completely snowballing the whole enemy team by mid to late game. His Q is really good. Has a really low cooldown. You can actually get that even lower. But it does a little AoE sweep. Keep it going. More damage. Most people don't understand about his W. Excuse me. You are healed for 20% of the damage these enemies take from any source. You're not automatically getting healed like he used to. Back when he was released, when you put his W up, you automatically keep on getting healed up. They nerfed that. So now you have to give damage to actually get any health back. So that's why the W Q combo is really good. E gives you a nice little charge. You can delay this by running around and building it up. You don't have to just directly go at your enemy. Now, I'm going with my masteries of 12, 0, 18, which Courage of Colossus, that procs off his E and his R, so that's going to help us when we dive in, and so we don't immediately die. So let's do this. So how are you guys doing? I hope your League Adventure is going good in Season 7. I hope you guys are getting up in the rank and doing well with yourselves. Alright, Bran, might want to go down there, I hope, Quinn. Getting playing top. Now, most people just spam his Q, but you're going to run out of mana really quick. So you need to time that, wait for the little countdown to come by. And always make sure you get that last hit on that camp so you have that time you can get to the next camp. So you're not completely wasting it, and I just missed it barely. So, what you guys want to see me play, leave a like and comment in the subscription. And we can get to that. I'm gonna do the Riot Point giveaway. $10. Just subscribe and comment. Who do you want to see me play as, and why? And we can do that. Now I like to go for a double QW combo and just help with my damage sustain a lot better. Let's see what we got going on. Annie's pushing up a lot, but I need my E. Now I go with Ghost instead of Flash. That helps me get to quicker procs with my E a lot better than anything. And most of all, it helps my passive. Alright, let's go get this. Nope. Always scared her away. To say at least. Well, she's too far up and I don't have it yet. Let's see. Right there. Pop. Now we're going to try that again. That's why I didn't pop my ghost or anything. I want to save that so when I have my E, I just do a full on charge and get that burst damage. Now we got it. She's backing. To play as a good jungler, you always gotta keep your eye on the main map. You can't even really look away sometimes. You have to constantly be looking, darting down, seeing what the position of everybody is so you can anticipate a strategic attack. Alright, now that bot is overpushed, we're gonna try going down that way. and it looks like they're warding. So, this is gonna be. Oh, yeah, I lost vision of them. Oh, that's why. What are you doing, huh? There we go. See how I moved off to the side just so I can push her back. Uh-oh. Get her. There we go. Good job. Alright, we need it back. Momentarily. This will give us enough time to get our... You know, shop a little bit, but also for our blue buff to come back. Now, I'm sorry I haven't been playing as much. I've been trying out other games and putting my hand into Paragon and Gears of War, Overwatch, Rainbow Six. Just seeing, just getting a feel for different things around there. Excuse me, guys. Just need to clear my throat. Alright, here we go. Let's get Grump. By the time, yeah. Blue buff will be back. I want to make a play in bot lane. But I mean, so far 2-for-1 is pretty good. And there's blue. I mean, I've... Pretty much, I like how Season 7 is going so far. The changes they've made have been really beneficial, especially towards a jungle main like myself. Brand needs to go back down. Alright. Where are you going? I got her! Oh, what? That... kill steal. That honest to God kill steal. I even charged and knocked her. That's weird. Alright, let's go over and see what Gangplank's up to. Oh, yep, you get out of here. Nah, just showing a little dominance. I mean, 3 assists, I don't mind. As a jungler, I don't mind actually getting assists and dying. I just want my team to do good. As long as my team is doing good and we win, I don't care about how many kills I get in the game. Alright, let's get red. No such one as that or blue. Oh, Fizz. Good job. Pop. All right, that was all good. That was really weird right there. I attacked and he just kept on walking, so that might have been a bug. I don't know how to explain that one. But we're going to go for Cinder Hulk just so we have that little AoE burn. And I'm not going with this suggested of Ninja Abby. I'm going to go with White Boots of Swiftness, which helps build on my passive, Warpath. Most people forget about that. That's why I have Ghost. That's why I sit around getting like Triforce. Alright, let's show some love down here. Uh oh. Oh my god. Come here. Smite him. There he goes. He slowed. Good job, guys. This Bran, he did not want to play support, and he's being overzealous. Oh. Cool. Get back. Oh, come on. There we go. Purge of Colossus. Right there. Helped me survive the fucking... everything that was coming at me. That is still... they said they nerfed it, but... to me, there is no nerf on that. It's still really overpowered. And I can proc it twice with two of my abilities, so... and it's on a low cooldown. You don't get much better than that. So where are we going next? We need to push towers. Okay. I'll get Grump first and then get there. I like playing Cinder Hulk. It gives me like a little AoE damage, but it'll give me some health too. So when I jump in, it boosts up my courage and Colossus and keep me alive a lot longer in fights. And I'll get my boots of swiftness as my tier 2 boots. Then I'll focus on my Triforce just so I can have that nice burst damage. And it helps synergize with all my abilities. Let's get Scuttle. Vladimir does not look like my help right now. Alright. Let's go. Smited her. Get off of my eye holes. Oh, that was the ult waste on your half. Good job, bot lane. Got that tower. I mean, honestly, I think we're doing pretty good right now. 3-0-5. My whole team is doing very good. On their team, not so well. Kind of deciding if we're going to make another play here or we're going back. Because there's no point of saving up gold, especially. There's no point of saving gold. You want to get back, you want to spend it so you can have that resource so you have more damage or more sustainability or be able to save money a lot longer. So, my advice, back when you can. Especially if you're a jungler, just so you can have, some room to breathe. Alright. Alright, we're taking this tower now. Because I need Vladimir Roman. Build this up and
got it.
So you can build this E up by running around and scattering around just to pock up the charge a little bit bigger, and then you can use it even on turrets to help burst that down. Oh wow. Okay, we need it back now. And finish up our Super Hulk. There we go. Phage already, so let's get some more mana. Alright, now let's... Alright, now we're gonna start having some more fun. It's really funny because I've been playing a lot of other different games where I have to, like, move around with WASD, so my fingers automatically go right there, and sometimes that's screwed up. Which is not intentional. Oh shit, party time. Party time. Let's go. Oh, still got a ghost, still got a ghost. Leave me alone. Oh, alright. He's dead. Yep. Oh, yes! Oh, no. Oh, wow. Wow, I thought I was dead right there. She had me stunned. I might be dead here, because, oh no, Sejuani's going after Bran. Alright, that was a good run. Alright, here we go. We might be able to sneak this dragon. Out of all the dragons, Infernal and Cloud Dragon are probably the best on Hecarim, because you can get around the map a lot quicker. It helps with passive, gives you more damage, especially if you proc it with your E, and then you just go charging in there and do a shit ton of damage. It's so beautiful. This is why I like Hecarim. And you know, he's not that hard to master, so anybody can pick him up. You just gotta keep an eye out for his movements, because he can get tricky at times. Alright, I wanna ward down. Right out there, because I know Sejuani will. Alright. Come on out here. Come on. There we go. Alright, there you go. That was nice. We're right here, it looks like Terrence is dead. Kate's not helping. Eight and 21, I think this might be... I'm not gonna put anything ahead of it because they can always still come back. My word advice, never surrender, just keep going. I've turned around 4v5s and defeated plenty of times. You don't have to be, you know, LCS fucking player to do good in this game. So yeah, wait for the proc and boom, there's damage. You can watch the counter raise up until you get about 100, and then you can just dive right into a tower and pretty much knock it down, which is what Hecarim should be all about. See, I'm at that point where I'm just like beyond snowballing. All I'm out. Later. That's why I love Courage Colossus. I can just dive in there and still get my kills, get whatever I need, and still be able to live to survive the telltale. Alright, there is three here. I'm not totally confident that I will live past this, but I really need to get my trifles. So I'm going to back, and we're going to go back in from there. And then, you know, I'll get my gauge. That helps me survive any kind of burst damage that I have, especially an Annie and a Gangplank. They pop at me, I'll be able to survive that as well. Sorry. Ugh. Oh, what's going on, guys? See, they're not surrendering. It's good. It makes it more fun. Ooh, hoo, hoo. So nice. So nice. So nice. So nice. Now, wolves. Wow, why so many traps? Wait for the proc, and boom. Alright, I think it's time to rotate. Is this Annie feeding? Can't tell. But alright, she's trying to get her stun ready. Not quick enough. Not quick enough. Fuck off. Ah, stay too long. I was just trying to save Bran, but I stayed way too long right there. 8-1 is not bad at all, in my honest opinion. Alright, which dragon coming? Oh, okay, Inferno, we have to get that. Vladimir's just been focusing that top lane. I mean, if we had him, tell Brandon go back. We need him full mana and healthy. And I need this blue. Oh, come on. I told you, man. I just need to go back. Oh. Where are you going? Where are you going? Where are you going? Hi. Come on. There we go. Did we get him? Yeah, we got it. My life for a dragon any day. Now, let's get Demi's plate so we can recharge in there. It gives us even more damage. Yeah, I think that's about right. No worries. Love that skin though. Alright, we need to probably go top. Alright, so Joanne's going there, so she's trying to push that weight. So let's watch. Bye. Alright, I'm out. Can't stay in that shit too long. But at least we took care of Andy. What is he doing? Alright, let's move. Ooh, good job, Fizz. Man, once the Fizz starts, like, going to town, there's no stopping. Alright, here we go. And. Bop! That's why another reason why I love Hecarim. He has such map dominancy. He can be anywhere at times. Hi. Hey. Where you going? Oh, she flashed right into me. That was fucking. That was great. That Central Line didn't know what was on the other side of the wall. They just wanted out Quint. And she flashed right on top of me. Alright, we're doing this. Alright, this is. Alright, we need to push this tower right out. I don't know what Brand is doing. I wish I knew what Brand was doing. I want to try to pull them out of that tower. Alright, hold on. Let's rotate. Get them off. Because they're gonna sit right on top of that turret. Alright, see, I'm channeling, and boom, damage. Which helps a lot when you're taking out a tower. Oh, I did that right up close. See, as you can see, it doesn't really do that much more damage. Alright, we just open that up, and. Man, you don't hurt at all. You do. I gotta get out. Oh, wow. Well, as I can see, I was gonna die anyway, but what can you do? Alright, where do I wanna go next? You know what? Let's go for a kill button. Yomu's is probably one of my favorite items because, like I said, it's kill button mode. You just click it and whatever champion you have, you're just going to go to town on them. I don't even think we're going to need Baron at this point, but unless they make a gigantic turnaround. Oh wow, Fizz. That damage. That damage. Oh my god. Just give him the penna. Wow, just give him the penna. Well, like I said, I don't think we're gonna need Baron. Would be fun just to grab it, but nope, get away from him. Ah, I was trying to kill him before he went invulnerable. Alright, still down. Where are you going? Oh wow, Sejuani jumped right on me. But not bad at all. We can go ahead and probably end it. 15-4? Pretty good. What is that damage on him? Lich Bane, Zhonya's. Pistol Scepter, Sorcerer's Shoes, and he hasn't even got a rabbit on yet. That's pretty good for him. What is all our stat? 21-4. Wow. I'm 15-4. Quint is 8-4. Our support is 6-8. Our top is 2-12. 2-4. Wow. It's not bad. I'm guessing if we fuck this play up and we go Baron, that's it, game over. And they jump us, because they're all alive right now. Yeah, they're scouting ahead. No Baron. Rotate. Legendary. Alright, they're all mid. They're all going after my team. So I'm going to take care of this inhibitor and try to end it. Because this is getting sad. Oh, never mind, they surrender, so GG. Well, it's been fun, guys. I appreciate you watching. Just like and subscribe for more. And y'all stay amazing. We'll see you next time. Have a good one.